To access the settings on the controller, just press and hold S. Here you'll be able to modify many of the controller settings. In Display, you can add or remove display screens that appear on your LCD screen, scroll through them using the directional buttons, and R1 to toggle them Show for on or Hide for off. The Light menu lets you change the drone and controller LED colors. In Control, you can choose between Attitude Control and Position Control. Position is the default. This setting only applies to when you're piloting the drone with the controller. In Attitude Control, the drone doesn't use the optical flow sensor on the bottom of the drone to stabilize its flight. The movement can be a little more dynamic and responsive, but also less stable. In Position Control, the drone uses the optical flow sensor to stabilize its flight. It tends to be more stable, but less dynamic. You can tell which control setting you are using by the A or P in the top left corner. For the Codrone EDU JROTC Edition, manual is the same as attitude mode. The mode menu lets you change between control modes. In mode 1, the left joystick controls pitch and yaw, and the right joystick controls throttle and roll. Mode 2 is default. The left joystick controls throttle and yaw, and the right joystick controls pitch and roll. In mode 3, the left joystick controls throttle and roll, and the right joystick controls pitch and yaw. Mode 4 is just mode 2, but with the joysticks swapped. The left joystick controls pitch and roll, and the right joystick controls throttle and yaw. The mode you're in is indicated by the M located in the top left corner of the screen. In quiet mode, you can turn the controller's beep sounds on and off. This is useful for larger classrooms where you might not want every controller beeping with each button click. You can tell whether quiet mode is on by the audio icon on the screen in the middle. The headless setting lets you turn headless mode on or off. Normally, when the drone takes off, forward is just where the front of the drone is pointing. Headless mode means that when you take off, the direction that the drone is pointing is always forward. So whether you've rotated left or right, the direction the drone was facing when it took off is always forward. It takes some getting used to, but headless mode means that you don't have to keep track of which direction the drone is facing after it takes off. You can tell which setting you're in by the N for normal or H for headless in the top left. Speed just lets you change the speed of the drone. It's the same as pressing L1 during piloting the drone. You can tell what your speed is by the S1, 2, or 3 in the top corner of the screen. Under Function, you are able to perform a sensor reset that will recalibrate the gyroscope. Make sure the drone is on a flat surface when doing a gyroscope sensor reset. This menu also lets you start the pairing process and reset everything to default. Exploring your controller is a great way to get familiar with what kinds of information your drone's sensors are able to pick up and what kinds of data it keeps track of. Whenever you're ready to learn about coding, you'll be able to access all the sensor data to gather information and make decisions. Happy flying out there! Did you miss our video on controller features or need a refresher? You can also go back and learn about the different controller display screens here.